Hello everybody, it's Mark here, and today I'm going to be streaming Sonic Mania. I do intend on actually finishing the game, getting to the end. I'm going to try and get all the Chaos Emeralds. I'm not too confident in the one special stage, so I might not, but either way I intend on finishing it. It's one of my favorite games, ones that came out in the past few years, and I'm a lifelong Sonic fan, so it's got a lot of references to the old games, which I've loved. Alright, so let's get at it. Oh, and I'm playing with an Xbox controller. I'm normally a keyboard guy. I know it's sacrilege, but yeah, I'm going for the full retro experience today. Okay, so Mania mode. As you can see, I've got save games for all the characters. So I'll go for a no save. Let me just see the game options. Time limit on, Mania. Yeah, it's all good. Go for Sonic and Tails. This is the intro to Sonic 3. Sort of, at least. I love how Eggman's minions all look like him. He's such a narcissist. Phantom Ruby. Warped reality. Or maybe Sonic's been having some illicit substances, who knows. Considering how trippy everything else is in his world, I wouldn't be surprised. Now, although this level appears in the original Sonic, it is quite remixed. There's a lot that's new, a lot that's different, yet a lot that's familiar. The layout, the little gimmicks and gadgets. Bonus stage. For those of you who know Chaotix, you'll recognize this as the claw game that you use to select your characters, except it's modified a bit here. Normally you'd get the blue spheres game, but since I completed all the blue spheres, even on the new save, it pretty much removes them. Ah, crap. Too bad. I'll try not to play this too often unless I actually get a reason to do it. I love the pixelated retro aesthetic. Those of you that know the Saturn and the early 32-bit consoles will see the similarity there. Now what's cool about playing as Tails is that you can get into Airlift Sonic. Well, might help if I knew I was more cautious about where I'd go. Double jump and become a root magnet. Come Tails. Need help. I don't remember where the gigantic ring is. I think it's here somewhere. First boss coming up. Yeah. This is fine, I do not need all those rings in any case. I know that if you hit the sign and get it to land in a different place, a monitor might pop up. But that's fine, I'll make do. Go to hell. This is one of my favorite parts in Sonic Mania. Get this fire shield. And burn. Burn that bridge. Who says burning bridges is such a bad thing? Lives and other stuff up here. I think that's going to lead me to the boss, so I'm just going to avoid it. I just want to get that stupid mega ring. Can I go back? Oh, that sucks. Here comes the Death Egg Robot. Kind of funny because this was the last boss in Sonic 2. Now he's the first one in Sonic Mania. And very easy. My poor tree. The leaves got cut off. Oh well. cutscene time. Go to help. Hello there. How do you pronounce your name? Poimtimi? Sorry, I'm really not sure about that. Would you forgive me if I pronounce it wrong? Welcome to the channel. Wish me luck. These special stages are quite tricky. Although this one's not too bad. Misjudged. Clearly I need to get my spectacles fixed. So I need to catch this UFO with the Chaos Emerald. The blue spheres make me go faster. The rings give me more time. I seem to have overrun it there. All good to me. So that's one emerald down, six to go. I actually meant to go up there, but good thing with the tails. Come on, little guy. Get me up there. Get me up there. Yoo-hoo! That's why I went down. I'm probably gonna lose another life when I come out, but that's fine. At least I'll still have an emerald if I get it. Okay. I'll go up to Mach 3, which is fast as you can go. Now I just need to catch up. Try to overtake this UFO. It's not really that difficult. Hi, Purple Spectre. You watched the Sonic movie the other day and liked it a lot. Yeah, it's very good. A lot better than I was expecting, and I would definitely say it's one of the best video game movies. That and Detective Pikachu. Thoroughly enjoyed it. Where's the UFO gone? Gotta overtake it again. There it is in the distance. Get back here. Ah, so far away. Well, my time is still good, so I can catch up to him. I'll just grab a little ring here and there just to ensure all is well. Come on, come on. Getting closer. Ah! Purple Spectre. Oh, for sure. Definitely one of the few good gaming movies. Yeah, it's terrible. I was speaking to Armin today and saying to him that it breaks my heart. There's so few good video game movies. I don't know what other video game movies you guys have watched. Like the original Mario Brothers movie. That is so bad. And the Mortal Kombat movies. Jeez. Terrible, terrible, terrible. And you know, it's not that you can't make an interesting story out of them. I mean, we were watching the movie for Mortal Kombat 11, all the cutscenes, and it's actually, you can, you can actually make an interesting story out of it. It's a bit cheesy, sure, but still fun and watchable. It's interesting to think that a video game studio actually made a 3.5 hour long movie in the game that was far more competent than what Hollywood can produce. There's another lodge ring around here somewhere. I'm not too sure. I'm very likely mistaken. There you go, Tails. See? I'm a good friend. Purple Spectre says that he liked the Prince of Persia movie. I have to admit, embarrassingly, that until recently I did even not know that there was a Prince of Persia movie. Armin pointed out to me. We'll have to check it out sometime. Detective Pikachu was very good too. Indeed it was. Now, I'm not even a Pokemon fan, and I enjoyed it. It was just a whole lot of fun. We went to go and see it in the theaters. I think the problem is a lot of the movies kind of ignore the source material. A lot of the producers think that they can make better things, and every time they do that, the result is always abysmal. I mean, like, the Resident Evil movie, it's kind of trashy, but I actually enjoyed that. They did sort of ignore some of the source material, but not too much. I mean, yeah, it's a good zombie flick. I love this material. Whoop, whoop, whoop. Liked it because of the dark theme, I'm sure. Huh. I'm a beautiful child of the light, don't you know? Full of purity and goodness. Hey, look, I'm playing Sonic. It's such a cute, fluffy little game. Sonic is such a cute little hedgehog thing. Sort of an anime Mickey Mouse. Okay, so yeah, you can choose which way you want to go. left, right, up. I'm gonna go up. Up, down, left. Left will take me back to where I was, so I'll go down. Ugh. Let's go left. It's like being an intersection again. I wanted to go down there. Oh well. Barrier. That sucks. Yes, the Konami code. Up, down, left, right, B, A, select, start. Used to be an old show here in South Africa. Some of the older generation will remember it. They used to play Sonic, and people would phone in and try and guide him. Like on the phone, they would say, left, left, right, right, jump, jump, left, left. And I think everyone from our generation knows that and associates Sonic with that. It sounds a bit silly when I describe it. I suppose it kind of was silly, but I think a lot of kids tune in just for that. Ah, so many squished hedgehogs. Oh well, I'll take this DNA strand. Now see, this is a Knuckles only path. Sonic can't break through there, but Knuckles can. I seriously don't think that this factory would pass any safety standards. So don't get squished. You remember that show, Purple Spectre? Huh. It's crazy. KTV. Saturday mornings. Crazy. Catch the UFO. Some people have been doing this for their whole lives. Come back here, UFO. You got lots to answer for with all your probing. I'll make you pay. Tank never gonna probe me again. Corners here where I can. Also need to get the rings. Keep the timer going. Thank you. to give me a few rooms to keep the timer at bay. Come on, come on. I'm really not used to using a controller. My hands are super sweaty. Your regular console player types. Is there any way that you can avoid the sweatiness, or what do you do? Because it's stopped getting annoying after a while. No, I'm gonna run out of time. Ah, stuff you. This stage makes you anxious. Wait until you see the other ones. At least I gotta continue. Came through the other way, so. Okay. Actually didn't mean to do that. It's fine, I'll just get out of here quick. Bye bye, Sonic. Okay, that's like a total change of pace. Puyo Puyo against Dr. Robotnik. Match 4 of these beans. Purple Spectre says you just wash your hands and lots of soap makes them dry and they don't sweat. Okay, I'll bear that in mind next time. In case you're wondering what the hell this has to do with Sonic, Puyo Puyo is an old Tetris-like game. Match 4, make these little beans match together if they're the same color. The idea is that you set off a chain and it kind of screws over your opponent. Every time you make a good chain, it drops like a junk bean that can't be matched, but can be cleared if you clear Puyo's next to it. And they rebranded this in North America with Sonic characters. Dr. Robotnik's Mean Bean Machine. It's a nice little Easter egg for fans of the series. And me personally, I love Puyo Puyo very much. It's very Tetris-like, but much more competitive. You are literally supposed to try and screw the player over. The Robotnik AI in this is not too bright, so it's very easy to win against him. There is a separate Puyo Puyo mode in Sonic Mania's options, so if you just want to play this, play with a friend, great. Come on. Oh, thanks. Purple Spectre says I'm good at Tetris. Armand is much better than what I am, though. And there goes Dr. Robotnik. Poor guy. He needs to learn his, he needs to up his Puyo Puyo game. They're actually on Steam. There's a Puyo Puyo versus Tetris, where you can play both at the same time. It's pretty trippy. And apart from Tetris Effect, I would say that's one of the better Tetris games you can get. I love the music to the stage. Very jazzy. I'm going this path because I know that there's a giant ring here. More steps for stage. Armin is a math genius, so it's unfair. True that. Let's try this again. The stage looks synthwave. Definitely a synthwave inspiration there. It's also one of the few stages in Sonic Mania that is original. A lot of the other stages are remixes from previous games. Think of Sonic Mania as kind of like a greatest hits compilation of Sonic with some original stuff. I'm going to try and catch up to this UFO earlier in the stage. Previously what I was doing was trying to get all my Mach speed up, but that didn't work. I ran out of time. So Mach is good, except that the faster you go, the harder you are to control. Sonic might be the fastest thing alive, but he said nothing about good traction. Come here, you piece of crap. Emerald thief. Screw you. Damn straight, I got a Chaos Emerald. Man, Sonic fights against gravity on this one. Good thing you got the spin dash. Well. Sonic might be super heavy. Yeah, he's chunky. Aerodynamic, but chunky. That's my fault. Come here, Tails. Good work for you, boy. Don't do this at home, kids. Do not get in the back of strange vans. Hate these things. That sucks. I better not get through that wall. I don't know if it's a knuckles on the wall. It's up here. Oh well. Let me try another path. Yeah. I thought there might be something down there. Clearly, I was right. Bottomless pit. Do not touch the robot performances. They damage. You meant it. Paparazzi bug bots. So crazy. Oh, hello. Another ring. This is the stage I usually have trouble with. Sucky sucky. No losey ringy. You get a time penalty from losing rings, so avoid. Yeah. Avoid the holes too. Skid, skid, skid. Gonna have to fight these hard-boiled heavies, elite troops, and Dr. Eggman's army. This one, you just avoid the missiles, except the blue ones. Ah, shucks. Hit the blue one and send it spiraling out of control. Ah, shucks. Get it. Man, I'm sucking hard. It was a good idea to check the rockets that shoot out, and you can tell which one's going to be the blue rocket. And he's going to smash into the helicopter. Mario actually inside a studio. Egg TV. Nah. Probably charge too much for it. And full of stupid ads. Oh, you're going to be very upset, this swirly-whirly evil thing. Ah, it's already here. I remember, kids, we don't endorse gambling. Lady Luck spits into my face. here. Thought there was a secret room there. Let's try this again. I'm trying to get the ring box there. Launch spits me out there. Nothing up there. You don't want to go into those bonus stage, I'll just wait for those rooms, those stars to disappear. I want to see what's on the other side of that. Last time. I think of your weather report. flying battery. And it's not double A either. Sure there's something up here. Goodies. Computer mice in the ceilings and floors. Fire shield makes me invulnerable to fire. I know there's a secret monitor there. I do not want to fall to the ground in this one. That was dumb. Just a one up there. Oh, that's fine. I guess you could say I've got a magnetic personality. Don't let the spiked balls land on my head or squish me. Come on. Hey, Tails, need your assistance. These bombs bond away. Okay. Total Star Wars reference here. Being in the garbage chute. Having the shield makes this boss trivial. Poor big guy. ship is ginormous. What the hell does Robotnik need such a huge ship for? Such a narcissist. Like certain world leaders. Go through there. Some of these guys are flying. Not for long though. Spider-Man. Okay, well, I guess one's gonna go that way. Ah, your projectiles are mock them. Pathetic. Really? He's on me anyway? Lame. This ship is like a huge city, just about. Yeah. Hey Tails, come here, make yourself useful. Never mind, got the one up by myself. Damn wind. Let's see what's on top there. Ah. Well, nothing much apparently. Whirly, whirly, twirly, whirly. Fine. No, don't dump me here. Push me in the trash. Take offense to that. No tails. This is my least favorite boss in the game. You can't damage it directly. You have to smack it into the spikes on the sides. Watch out, don't smack yourself in the spot. Yeah, we're gonna run out of time soon. There we go. This is one of my personal favorite levels in the game. Some sort of weird printing press, ancient temple, winter wonderland. All good. I know that there's one of those big rings down here. So let's try that again. Did it again. That'll be a bit better. I'm going to try to go into that printing press. Oh, what a feeling, running on the ceiling. Silly kids shouldn't play with razors. Oh, of course. Oh, that's a death trap. Hmm. guy to hurt his saw. It only hurts it on those brown boxes. I really love the look of this next level. It's a real winter wonderland, but like those Japanese trees, I forget their name. Maybe someone in the chat could help me remember them. One of these purple leaves. Cool. I'm frozen, but no biggie. Trees with bombs in them. Pulping machines. So those blue rings, they make it so it's easier to recollect my rings if I lose all of them. Rather than all my rings scattering, it only makes it so that there's a few rings. See? Three or four larger ones. What am I doing? Super speed and super shoes. Just knock it off. Looks like there should be something there, but I can't get it. Yeah. Oh well. Let's hope it isn't a bottomless pit. Crushed by the ice. Just want to get comfortable. Let's see where this ice takes me. See, being frozen is good. So helpful. Thank you. shit. Break and stay broken. Go away. Oh, Robotnik. Causing trouble again. Another level whose music I like a lot, but I mean, just about every single song in the Sonic Mania soundtrack is great. Nice down tempo, jazzy stuff. This one goes crazy with the springs. Mm-mm. Don't you even dare. Mm-hmm. Do not touch those red chomping mouth things. What a ride. Yeah. This place is such a death trap. It's insane. Hogwarts, shall I say. Come back. Come back here, you fool. Such an inefficient use of energy. And now go into the future. Definitely one of my favorite levels in the whole thing. So bright and colorful. So upbeat. The whole design looks like a massive, like a trumpet or some other types of instruments. This is also the level where you meet Metal Sonic. Destroy that Metal Sonic hologram. Kind of annoys him, brings animals out. Fine. Now comes a race. A reference to Chaotix, where he plugs himself into some of Robotnik's machines. Hmm. and spawns lots of little robot Sonics. Not that it does him any good. That can't be good. Yeesh. Go away. Stupid bug kicked up the Phantom Ruby before I could get to it, but that's part of the gameplay. Robotnik! Fine. Disappear. See if I care. Hydrocity. Some pronounce it Hydrocity, but that doesn't sound right to me. Not a huge fan of water levels in Sonic games, but this is alright. Besides, I got this bubble shield to protect me. Which one do I choose? Sharks are bad enough, but torpedo sharks? You ain't gonna have a good day with them. Before I go there, what's over here? I mean, I can explore with having the shield and everything. I don't have to worry about my oxygen running low. Poor Tails is about to drown. Stupid jellyfish. Bye bye, Tails. I barely knew him. Oh, there's his replacement. Oh, that didn't take long. It's like there's a whole factory somewhere full of Tails. As soon as one dies, we'll ship out a new one. Go away. Yes, just made it. With nary a second to spare. Whoa, 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 whoa. Well, that sucks. Go on a gondola, because why not? More gondolas. It's like those memes that say that dolphins have returned to Venice after lockdown. Yeah. So Sonic apparently. This is probably the slowest stage in the entire game. Spend a lot of time in these bubbles trying to navigate. But that's cool. Sonic needs a change of pace. Not every level can be a roller coaster ride. So there's Dr. Eggman. Plant some bombs. Blows up the whole place, because, I mean, why not? Such an anarchist. So this is funny because in the original game, because this is a remix level, the situation is reversed. Dr. Eggman is in the machine and you're in the water. So this is kind of revenge. Use the drill to pull the water up and him with it. You can actually drop these charges. And in theory you can destroy the bombs, but I don't really find a good use for them. If they land on Dr. Eggman's head, they do nothing. They just bounce. Obviously you don't want to suck up those bombs, because they pretty much hurt. Boom. Come on. See? You fool. Cheers. This looks like an ancient aqueduct water canal. Pretty cool. Yeah, well, that's going to help me a lot. I like to think that those hands that come and grab me are like Mickey Mouse hands, complete with the cartoon gloves. Pretty sure that there's a ring here somewhere. Come back, Tails. There goes one. Let's try it again. Need a bit more momentum. Guess I was wrong. Dead wrong. Looks like there might be something interesting here. And I was right. Okay, do not go for that one ring over the lip. Every time I've done it, I've seen my butt. Mark 3. Here we go. Try and cut him off. Ah, gotcha. Piece of crap. So I've got three more to go. Ugh. So if I can do it. Yeah. Again. Man, I hate the spikes. That's the one I was looking for earlier. If I'd gotten that thing, I could have leveled up faster. The sucky part is that the spheres respawn, but the rings don't. So you cannot play it indefinitely. Time will run out. I don't think I'm gonna make it. I'm running out of time. Am I enough time? Yeah. Sucks. Well, at least I gotta continue. Spikes and more spikes. I think there's another ring up there. I think I might be wrong. done here. Uh-oh. Alright. Having the shield makes this boss a lot easier. Gotta activate these bombs and get Robotnik to smash into them. Can you imagine how dizzy he must be after this is done? Poor Tails is about to die. Not over yet. Spin cycle. I'm still not sure what the cool bonus is about. Poor Knuckles. Hello. In case you're wondering, there isn't any danger of me actually falling off the plane's wings. Only if I move very fast. But normal walking won't do that. It's basically just an auto-scrolling level. Well, part of it at least. My day seems to change as well. Oh, Eggman. He's having such a grand old time there. Hmm. catch the UFO. If I try. Missed it. Shucks. Considering how I ran out of time last time, I'll try and get as much time here as possible. Stupid jumps are very imprecise. How annoying. Well, that slowed me down. Go, Sonic, go. Well, that sucked. Back on the plane. Oh, polite. Another reference from the old Sonic games. Giant sandworm. Dead sandworm. Bark the Predator. Stupid thing. Totally movable barrel. Let's try that again. There we go, finally got that stupid thing. Okay, so I've reached Mach 2 a lot earlier. Yeah, this is so tough to avoid. Check those corners. Check those corners. Damn it. Thank you. Hello. All these characters that she's transforming into are references to characters from other Sega games, other Sonic games. Personal accent says, you know that part where you die? Yeah, don't do that. Gee, thanks. I'll bear that in mind. I thought I was doing something wrong. And onto the oil ocean. Always love how this level's got that sort of Arabic sounding music. Saw a big ring down there. How do I get it? I think I'm supposed to go that way. I feel like there should be something here. like a ring, big ring. Really, nothing? That's lame. Maybe they forgot to program it. Stupid meter droid. Well, apparently the meter droid was the only thing that was keeping the whole place from exploding. This place's air is so bad. Kills you if you leave it after a while. Careful killing those red sphere things that drop their fire into the oil, it ignites. Now I'm starting to lose rings from the toxic air. It is no good. Definitely better to harden that submarine because she's the air out here is so damn toxic. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Foot tails. Well, at least I've gotten as many hits as I could before he disappeared. Yeah, to hell with you, stupid octopus. Evacuate, that's a good idea. Monitor. Keep out! No, I refuse. Well, does look like that's breakable. Oh well. Again. get that platform to respawn. Or I can just get Tails to help me. Tails, you're a pal. Personal accent asks if I'm almost halfway. I'm a little bit past halfway. As far as I remember, there's still two more zones after this. Cool, 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 cool. Mark 2. Done and dusted. Sounds like a pesky UFO. Okay, Mach 3. Come on, come on, come on, come on. The UFO is outrunning me. Yes, that's quite a fast little UFO. That's how they avoid detection. Come on, no! Jesus, I was so close. Oh no, it's painful to watch. Didn't you really say that, personal accent? About not dying? Yes. I got it. Don't die. Dying equals bad. Gotcha. Loud and clear. You see, the problem with that stage was that I zigged where I should have zagged. I mean, that's like the most common mistake in the world. Massive rolling ball of death. Indiana Jones, are you proud? Suck less, Sir Slaxon says. I did try that. My physician says that I should try cutting the suck out of my diet. But I don't want to, it's too addictive. rising lava. Cool, cool. Oh, that was a risk I took. No, man. Other way. I kind of thought I still had my shield. I was gonna like dodge it. Pro tip, the floor is lava. Thanks, Personal Axon. I was kind of wondering why it was, you know, all hot and stuff. Damn. Okay. I'm gonna be less cocky on that point. No. Well, that went better than expected. Okay, well, I guess these platforms can be stood on. Wasn't sure about that. Machine. Mm-hmm. tell you about cheese. Well, it's a dairy product, cultivated usually from milk, cow milk that is. The milk of other animals also suffices, goats for example. I really like this music. So chill. Let's try that stupid special stage again. This time, don't die. I'll take her under advisement. So yeah, that's fine. Getting to Mach 1, not too bad. Thing is, by the time I get to Mach 3, I'm fast enough to catch the UFO, but controlling Sonic becomes near impossible. Well, okay, I'm exaggerating, but still. Much tougher than what he usually is. I'm gonna keep bouncing all over the place, hitting all the bumpers. Get. Go, Sonic, go. I'm fine. Is but a flesh wound. Can I bop off the birds? No, I can't. The birds are purely decoration. They have no... They aren't even physical. I like to think that this whole thing is like some weird fever dream of Sonic's. Getting closer, catching in, closing the gap. We're good. Hitting him off. Cutting him off shortly. Come on. Yes. How are you, special stage? I think I'm going to be able to get all the Chaos Emeralds. I've missed too many of them. I don't think there's any opportunities in the coming stages, but it doesn't matter. Oh, I just came through here. My bad. Thank you. nasty trap this is. Good thing I'm invincible. Even if just temporarily. Told you that not sucking is the key. You're welcome. Yeah, thanks. That was pretty life-changing advice. Have you considered writing a book? The Art of Not Sucking. Ooh, that was a risky jump. I'm not gonna make this. Damn, that was close. Come on. Good stuckaroony. Dr. Robotnik's ship in the background. Oh no, sorry, that's Little Planet. From Sonic CD. Rodeo. That's you gone. Here's one of my favorite gimmicks. You can actually jump into the background. Let's have another stab at the special stage, shall we? Mach 2, cool. Seconds on the timer. Killing those corners. Come on. Come to Papa. Yes. So 6 out of 7 chaos emeralds, not too bad, I don't think. I can hear the comments right now. It's sort of asking for a chirp. Go away. Small accent says it's good-ish. I mean your unwavering confidence in me warms my heart. Or it could be all the cholesterol, I don't know. I see what you're doing. Was not just here. Yeah, I was. So you mean going around circles? Boing. Well, that's red alert, huh? Silly man. Did you really think that goofy contraption would stop me? So, at this particular level, there's another gimmick where Sonic gets shrunk. I think Tiny Sonic is kind of cute. And these Russian doll bombs. Interesting idea. You can't hurt them, just avoid them. What are those Russian dolls called? The ones with, you open up the doll and there's another doll inside it? Mushkovet dolls, playing that effect? And there we go. Tiny Sonic. Even though he's tiny, Sonic still can kick butt. I mean, Mario's pretty much a force to be reckoned with, and he's tiny. Sir Swanlaxian says Matryoshka. I hope I pronounced that right. Thanks. Ugh. Yeah, I like these all. It'll take you between the foreground and the background. Okay, I can't move there. So I have to go into the background. And I get shrunk again. Yep, baby Sonic. So cute. Into the background once more. I really like this idea. It really makes the level a bit more complex. And if you think in actual three dimensions, wow. Yeah, this cracks me up because those balls that comes out of the machine sort of resembles Pokeballs. Or gumball machines. Yeah, Amy Rose, Sonic's unstable stalker girlfriend. So of course Dr. Robotnik made robots of her. Robot bombs. Come back here, you fool. I've busted all your toys. It's only a boss here we have to fight in shrunken form. Which was a nice touch. things just went dark. Scary. Yes, she's a robot bomb shell. Okay, that was good. Gotta admit. Alright, now we're in the home turf, the Titanic Monarch. This is Robotnik's home turf now. And subsequently the toughest level of the bunch. If you take a close look at the background, you'll see it's like a gigantic Robotnik statue. Sorry, Porkbot. Can't have you dropping bombs everywhere. Action says 50% egg, 50% man, 100% medical ethics violation. Between you and I don't think he's even really a doctor. And if he is, well, he has a lot of malpractice suits coming along. I mean, what sort of sicko makes a big machine just to squish innocent little hedgehog? I mean, really, this guy's got issues. I knew that was going to get me. I believed hope, in spite of hope, that it would not, but it did. Okay, avoid that. Again, that's annoying. How many lives I'm gonna squeeze out here? What a stupid spot to get stuck on. I mean, really. Go away. Stop targeting me. So this is gonna take me to the worst Uber driver in the world. You're getting a very bad review, sir. Oh, there's a ring down there. I'm not sure how to get to it. I think I might have missed it. Yeah. Oh well. Back to the Uber driver. I'm gonna do all these bombs. Oh, well, that wasn't the best idea. Just about a scratch. And a minor inconvenience. Shut up about that last emerald. Okay? Robotnik can't do shit with just one emerald. So, yeah. I think that's the way to go. Shut up with your butt. Not interested, not hearing it, nothing of the sort. Boink. La la la. Life is grand. Especially when you ignore the naysayers. I love that moon. Pretty. Piece of crap. Okay, worst elevator in the world. Easy. Yeah. Crimson Eye. Emeralds, unlike diamonds, are not forever. Okay, I'm sorry, Mr. Crimson Eye bot thing, but I've had enough of you. You're going down. Get it? Because we're in the elevator. You're going down. Come here. Piece of crap. That's not far to you. Okay. Absolute final level. Okay, so you need to do all four of these sections to complete the zone. Turtle. Stupid! This is the only level that it's kind of easy to get a time over. All these sections do take a while. I think Sonic Mania would have benefited from like a time item, something that adds like 10 seconds to the clock or 30 seconds or whatever, because these levels are friggin' long. Okay, so one more section. Thank you. she is done. The final battle. At least they're kind enough to reset the timer. You can't escape his hand, so just let him grab you and be done with it. Teleport you to another area with one of the hard world heavies again. You can defeat them again, but I've never been able to. I've just focused more on actually defeating Dr. Robotnik. And this gets easier as you fight, because a lot of these tentacles of his break. Easier to reach him. Fine, take me. I ain't afraid of where you're gonna bring me. Ooh, that's fun. Come on, get out of there. So I can kick your ass properly. Come on, that all you got? I ain't even breaking sweat here. Pathetic. Done and dusted. Now might be a good time to hide. Thanks, Max, you got our back. Sub 50 minutes? Jeez, what do you think I am? Fast? Yes, that's it, Sonic Mania. If I had gotten an extra Chaos Emerald, there would have been one final fight. That's like the best ending, but that's a good ending I still got all the same. There's also an encore mode where you can play slightly remixed versions of the levels. And instead of lives, you have all five characters at once. And you switch between them. Levels are quite a bit harder, and all the special stages are different and harder. Hmm. Hello. Hey, everybody. This is my unofficial mascot, Meat Hansel. And yes, he has a sister named Gretel. Oh, doesn't like being picked up. But come on. Say hello, Hansie. probably wants food. Always wants food. He's already eaten. One of the best soundtracks ever. I love this so much. T. Lopez was the composer. You should totally check his stuff out on YouTube. One of these days I might revisit it and actually get all the emeralds again, but right now I'm not too worried. Hello, Hansel boy. Just can't keep away from your daddy. Boy, can't seem too well on the camera, it's kind of dark. What is that? Ah, okay, well, that explains it. Daddy's boy. Nah, I'm not gonna play anything else. Kind of fatigued from this. So colorful, so vibrant, so upbeat. That's why I love playing these games, to make me feel like a kid again. Hey, Ansel. Yes. I'm just going to let these credits roll through. Come here, Gretel. I want to see if I can get Gretel to come and pose for the camera. Come, girl. Gretel, come here, girl. So, yeah, I call them Hansel and Gretel because they're strays, formerly ferals, and they were coming to the flat I was living in. I used excuse me. I used to leave food out for them. So the idea of this brother and sister duo coming and following the crumbs kind of brought to mind the story of Hansel and Gretel. And no, I'm not a wicked witch. nor do I feed them treats. Well, okay, I lie there. I feed them plenty of treats. These two are inseparable. Terrible twins. They follow me everywhere. It's like a second pair of shadows. I can barely step foot outside the front gate and they follow me. I can barely go to the bathroom and they follow me. Open up the door and they're waiting outside with this forlorn look on their face, as if the void swallowed me up. Isn't that right, boy? Yeah, no, well. Or do I have any more Sonic games? I think I will. This is something... I love the Sonic games. I just want to see what's at the end of the credits. I think that, it might show a little animation of Dr. Robotnik flaunting the emerald in my face. Yep. Try again. Mm-hmm. Might as well be giving me the middle finger. Cool. Now it gives me stats. Sweet. Hush, Dr. Robotnik. Okay, so that's Sonic Mania, beginning to end. I'm gonna exit out here. Thanks for watching and tune in next time. Cheerio!